gloveshop.com. You could order custom gloves, bats, fielding gloves, all sorts of stuff to match your team colors. And not only that, they make some super high quality products. I'm gonna tell you guys right now, out of all the batting gloves I've ever used, these are by far my favorite. I've used these for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of swings, and I have yet torn any of them. So if you use promo code THESWINGMAN, when you put your order in, you get 15% off your order. I promise you guys, just at least try one pair. If you're still hunting down for a good pair of batting gloves, try these out. Again, stingerwoodbats.com. And you know, try on a cool, neat color. I know they just came out with an all black one, which I'm excited to get soon. But go ahead and try it out. Let me know what you guys think.
See ya.
There we go.
Keep going.
Gone.
All right, there you go.
I feel like you got that one.
Number four, guys. Now this one, I'll explain to you for a little bit. This is what I call taking a full swing. Obviously, if we want to hit for power, we got to take a full swing. But by taking a full swing, what I mean is, we have to understand what our max point moving backwards is, and also how to read our swing when we take a nice full swing. If we're able to utilize our entire body and rotate all the way through our swing, then we know that we're balanced and we're able to accelerate and use our entire body to decelerate. This is gonna help prevent injury, but also this is gonna tell us that we're maximizing our movements in our swing. So if you feel like you're taking swings and your dad's, you know, saying, you know, finish your swing, you know, finish high, or you're taking check swings, I know you guys aren't trying to do this, but this is a sign that something's going wrong before your swing even starts. You're decelerating through the zone, and that's what we don't want to do. We want to always accelerate through the zone. I call it point A and point B. Point A is when our front heel lands and we're right in that position where we're about to fire. That's point A. Point B is when we are following through to the top of our shoulder right here. That's point B. If we could accelerate the bat through those two points, then we're gonna have power to all fields. Because it doesn't matter if we're early or if we're late, if we're able to accelerate on point A to point B, if we're slightly off with our timing, we're still going to drive the ball out of the park. So if you're watching a major league game and you see a guy hit a middle in pitch out to right center for a home run, and you're like, how the heck did he do that? It's because he developed good bat speed and bat path through point A and point B, to where he mistimed that ball and he still got good barrel on it with his body behind it, and great things happen when you could do all those things. So understanding that we got to take a full swing, not only at the plate, but the best way to go about this to make sure you're doing it is our warm-up swings. We want to make sure that we could develop a nice whoosh to the bat, a nice sound of that bat going through the air with minimal effort. All right, almost if you guys ever swung a fungo, that swoosh sound, but we want to do it with our regular bat. So I'm just going to show you some practice swings, the difference between being too short, being too long, and then being right where we want to be. All right, guys, so if I'm on deck and I'm getting ready to hit, what I want to avoid is being too small with my load back. So what I mean, if I'm timing the pitcher and I'm doing this, okay, I'm not maximizing my stretch of that rubber band, okay, that start to that kinetic chain. And also, at the same note, I don't want to get too big back. All right, or this here, okay? Now I'm just stretching too far, okay? And I'm not getting everything in line with each other. So when I'm going on deck, what I wanna make sure is I have nice, solid, and smooth rhythm. So if you ever see me on deck, it's gonna look something like this. I'm gonna get here in my stance. I'm gonna get back with that nice stretch and that nice full swing to where I stay balanced over that middle part of my body. So here, back, stretch, swing. Okay, here, back, stretch. Back, stretch. Swing. All right, so I'm taking that nice time to understand my body, where I have to get to back here in my strength, because I want to get there obviously as I'm deciding whether or not I'm going to attack. Okay, so getting to that point of that maximum controlled stretch is very important when it comes to developing proper power. All right guys, so I'm gonna show you in my intro video that I use for my videos now what I'm talking about. So basically you'll see every clip I have is right at the start of that stretch, right there. You could see where I maximize a point where I'm pulling back, and it allows me to throw the barrel with my backside, my shoulders and my hands right in that area to maximize that bat speed through the hitting zone, as I mentioned. So this is something that you want to work on. Even with your practice swings, you want to try to feel that nice loud swoosh with your bat through the hitting zone. Obviously if you're younger, it's going to be tougher to do, maybe using a lighter bat like a Fungo to really get that noise, but the older you get, you should be able to develop that with a normal bat. One thing we want to make sure we don't do is we overstretch or over rotate backwards. So a good way to practice that is make sure that your head and your eyes could stay lined up with the pitcher's mound or where the pitcher should be standing. And we want to practice that stretch of the core and that rubber band that we talk about before we attack the zone. So if you guys have any questions, just leave them in the comments below. I hope this one helped. It is a little difficult to explain, so feel free to ask me if you have any questions. Go back, watch the clips of my hits too to help you out. But thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned. I'll have my fifth and final power tip coming up soon.